Are you thinking about buying a home, but you've never done it before and you're not sure what it takes to get a loan or if you would even qualify? Well, that's what we're going to talk about today. Hi, and welcome to my YouTube channel. On this channel, I talk about everything that you need to know about buying, selling, or investing in real estate right here in Lake Havasu City. If you haven't already, go ahead and subscribe and hit the bell so you are reminded every time I have a new video. We are lucky today to have a special guest, Dara Paddock, with us from High Tech Mortgage.
Thank you.
She has done a video with us before, but just in case you missed the first one, Dara, would you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Thank you for having me. I'm Dara Paddock. I'm from High Tech Mortgage, the longest running local lender here in Lake Havasu. We are located right on Main Street. I am the branch manager and loan officer, and I'm here to talk a little bit about what you got to do to finance a home.
Awesome. Let's get started. So be sure to watch the video to the very end, and I will share with you some of the bloopers that Dara and I made today. Let's talk about first-time homebuyers. We know that there are three things that you need to have in order. You need to have income, credit, and assets.
You do.
So let's talk about assets first.
Perfect.
Great.
So you'll need to save up for a down payment. We know that some lenders have down payment assistance programs, so be sure to check with your lender to find out if that's a program that they offer. Okay. But for the most part, save up your down payment and make sure that the funds are in your bank account. Don't deposit any cash or have any random non-payroll deposits because there are very strict rules with assets, and we have to be sure to consult your mortgage rep before making any random deposits to save yourself the headache in case you go ahead and deposit it and then it's too late, can't undo it.
So why is that important? Can you give us an example?
Absolutely. So if you were to sell something and you were planning to use the money for your down payment and closing costs, there are specific rules that we have to follow. There are documentation requirements we have to get to show that you owned the asset that you were selling, a bill of sale, make sure that there's no cash involved. It has to be a paper check or an electronic transfer. So there's very strict rules where down payment and closing cost money can come from.
Okay. So what can you tell us about employment and income?
So make sure to work as many hours as possible to solidify your income and make it look like your income is sustainable and likely to continue. Underwriters and lenders definitely want to see that your income is stable. And then try to avoid changing jobs a lot. And if you do have to change employment or change jobs, try not to have any gaps. So if your income is full-time or your employment is full-time, we don't necessarily need to see a full two-year history on that same job. We only need to see a two-year employment history with little to no gaps in it, if possible. And then if your employment or your income is part-time, then we do need to see you on that same job for the most recent 2 years. And then there are strict rules to follow with employment and income as well. We have to make sure that it's sustainable, it's guaranteed or likely to last for the next 3 years. And we can't use anything like roommate or boarder income, or if you have a side job and you get paid cash under the table, those aren't applicable, those aren't allowed.
Hey, what do you think of this video so far? Go ahead and give me a thumbs up if you find that this content is valuable. And lastly, and probably the most important, is credit. So what can you tell us about credit?
A couple of things. So we need to make sure that your credit score is good, which means we need to make sure that your credit history is good. So you definitely want to be paying all of your monthly bills on time. For credit cards and revolving credit, try to pay down your balances as low as you can because that will help your score. And do not, I repeat, do not pay off old collections. Please let your lender review your credit report and let them advise you of anything that does or doesn't need to be paid off.
Oh, that's great advice.
Thank you.
So can you go into that a little deeper? Maybe some common credit misconceptions and kind of what makes up a credit score?
Absolutely. So what calculates your credit score? The credit companies like your Capital One, your auto loan, they report to the bureaus once a month, usually on your statement period, and then the bureaus collect that data and report that data to the credit reporting agencies. The credit reporting agencies are who you get your credit reports from. That's your Credit Karma, your freecreditreport.com, your Advantage Credit, Credit Plus. The agencies are the ones who actually use the algorithms to calculate your credit score. So there are five major factors that actually make up the calculation of your credit score. The first and foremost, this is the biggest, 35% of your credit score is made up of past delinquencies. So you definitely want to be paying your bills on time. The next biggest factor, which is 30% of your credit score, is made up of your revolving debt ratio. So that's why I say to pay your credit card balances down as low as you can. That's going to help your credit score. Once you hit the 50% of your credit card usage, you're going to see an impact in your credit score. And then once you go down even further to 30% of your usage, you're going to see an even bigger impact in your credit score.
It'll make your credit score better.
Better.
Awesome.
Correct. And then the last three items that affect your credit score, 15%, 10%, and 10%, they're very minimal, are the length of credit history, your mix or type of credit, and your inquiries and your new credit. So those don't weigh as heavy a factor as your paying your bills on time and paying down your credit card balances every month if you can.
So I know some people think that having a lot of inquiries or people running your credit really hurts your credit score.
And it has a very small impact on your credit score. So yes, in a sense, it does hurt you very temporarily, and it's a light ding on your credit.
Okay.
You're gonna bounce back very quick, but it makes up a small percentage of what your credit score calculation is. Also, the bureaus assume that you're gonna shop for mortgages, student loans, and auto loans. Mm-hmm. So as long as you have the same type of inquiry, you're allowed to have as many as you want in a small time frame, and it's only gonna count as one hard inquiry on your credit report.
Oh, perfect. So can you go back to the collection thing and kind of tell us some of the myths or misconceptions about that?
Absolutely. So basically, when we're talking about credit history, we want to see the longest credit history possible. So some of the misconceptions are is when you pay down or pay off an installment debt, that is eliminating credit history. And so you're losing your credit history, which makes up a portion of your credit score. So by paying down installment debt faster, you think you're helping your credit, but lenders don't look at that. They want to see the history there. So by eliminating the history or by paying it off and closing a credit line, you're eliminating your history and it's not helping your credit score. With collections sometimes will sit there dormant and it goes off of the date of last activity. That's what is most important in the credit score calculation. So if your date of last activity is 3 or 4 years ago on an old collection, especially a medical collection, because you know probably 75% of the population has a medical collection on their credit report, and lenders, you know, they know that. That doesn't have a huge impact when it comes to whether or not you're going to be able to finance a home. So when you have an old medical collection that's been sitting there for 3 or 4 years and it's $300, if you pay that off, you're going to be bringing the date of last activity current. It's not going to look like a 3 or 4 year old collection. It's going to look like a brand new collection. And whether it's showing as an open collection or as a paid collection, it's still reporting as a collection, and that's all they care about.
So if you have one that you haven't made a payment on in a couple years, don't.
Just I'm telling you, leave it there. If the lender requires you to pay it off, then we can go deeper into the best way to do that. We can handle that at that time. But don't think that you have to pay off old collections in order to qualify for a loan, because we do not want your credit score dropping immediately right before we pull your credit to qualify you.
Wow. And those are things that I wouldn't have known.
Yeah.
So probably the best and first thing to do if you're even considering getting a loan is talk to you or a lender first thing.
Yeah.
Months before you're ready to start doing anything.
Yeah. Let us get your monthly income. Let us calculate your debt to income ratio and let us have a peek at your credit, because there might be things on there that you weren't aware of. And you might think you have things on there that really don't show up because they're so old.
Great advice. Thank you, Dara. So Dara, I get asked a lot about first-time home buyer loans. Mm-hmm. Can you go into that a little?
So there is a common misconception about a first-time home buyer program automatically meaning you don't have to have a down payment.
Okay.
And while there are first-time home buyer programs, an extension of that would be a down payment assistance program. So not every lender offers that. Different lenders offer different things. Some lenders are retail lenders, meaning they lend their own money. Some lenders are mortgage brokers, meaning they choose a different lender to send your file to based on your needs. So not every program is the same. Not every program is perfect for the same person. And if you do get some kind of guidance or advice from a lender that just doesn't seem like it makes sense, don't hesitate to ask a different lender, because all lenders have different programs and different rules to follow. So you can ask around.
Dara, that was great information. Thank you so much for sharing that with us. If you have any questions about buying a loan, be sure to give Dara a call and she can walk you through the whole process.
Absolutely.
Thank you for watching this video today. My name is Carol Darrow. I'm a realtor at Destination Havasu, and I hope you think of me the next time you want to buy, sell, or perhaps you already own a home here and you're looking for a property manager. I'm here and I'm always happy to help. We'll see you next week.
And do not deposit any cash or any random non-payroll. So the first step would be to save up for your down payment. There are random.
Be sure to give Dara a call.